Hi everyone, welcome back to Train Sim World. Here we are by the river with a little town over there looking great. Lovely sunny day. It helps to keep the weather nice and warm and sunny. It does improve the frame rate no end. I've done a winter's blizzard where it really caused the frame rate a little bit of issues. It was down to about 12 or 13. Do you want to give up control? No! I'm control freak me. This train here is not our train sitting by this station. This train on the other line is our locomotive right there. Oh, we got a hard hat. That's our first collectible. Huzzah. So I'll show you where we are. We're right up here. Wandering ground. So this is where one of the this is where one of the coal mines are. And we've got the other coal mine down here, and we've got the main, wow, it's quite a long route as you can see. We've got the main yard, Cumberland Yard, down there. So, what we're going to do is, oh actually that might be another collectible up here. It is, one of 25 posters. Great. I'm just going to see if there's any more collectibles around here. So we're going to drive this locomotive down to the... Well, we're not going to go all the way because that'll probably take hours. And we've got a spade here, look. That's another collectible, is it? No, it's not. Okay. Stand down, everyone. I thought it was getting too good to be true. Can we open these wagons up? No. It appears not. Ah, I take that back. Any hobos in there? Climb into the... Oh, okay, we can get in there. So we've got some empty carriages. No hobos in there today. So that's good. If we can get this... How do we close this up? Just... there we go. Good stuff. So we've got some empty carriages. I think that's pretty much all we've got. We've got some... what looks to be some cylinders here for obviously carrying, what are we carrying? Don't know, some sort of liquid. Plate C, not quite sure. And we've got some coal cars, which we can't go all the way up to the top. Can we hop over? No, okay, fine. Well, we're gonna go back and do some driving. As I said, the frame rate is a little bit more pleasant up here. You're comfortably getting 30 frames a second in most of the areas. So if I bring up the gauge, there you go. Comfortably getting 30 frames a second. So it does seem to perform a lot better up here. Just make sure another train isn't coming and I don't get run over. So here's our locomotive just sitting here idling away. The lights are weird, green, and they've been wanting us to go for some time. That's why we got the... should we take control back off you? We got lovely Laura with us today. Hey Laura. She's a little bit absent-minded, bless her. She's, you know, she's one of those people, we just let her look out the window and she's happy. And everyone's happy if she's happy. Right, Laura? Yeah, good. Right. So let's get this train ready to go. We need to put the lights on to bright. Safety first. If anyone's done the tutorials, you'll know how annoying that gets. Then we do two honks of the horn. Great. That's in forward anyway. Make sure the brake is off. And we'll get going. So I thought after the last two videos, one was a bit of a moan video, the other one's just a bit of a fooling around video in the dark, I thought I'd bring you a proper route. As it's Monday, I'll bring you a proper route so you can see what's what. Ooh, let's give it some beans. We're obviously very heavy. There we go, we're moving. Gaining a bit of speed now. Obviously got a lot of weight to pull, so it's a bit of a slow start. Let's crank it up to number 4, as we got the mile an hour is coming up now. That's 6 miles an hour. Flying alongside the river, look at this. Oh, let's crack open the windows. Let that summer air breeze on in. Lovely. I wish there was a command to put your elbow out on the thing there and just kind of lean out. That would be good fun. Okay, here we are, back in the cab. Things are going great. Building up the speed nicely, coming up to 20 miles an hour. We have a speed limit of 40 currently, and 45 in about a mile. So that's all groovy. Yeah, performance is doing okay. I've realised something since the other thing. We've got a light up there. That would have been so useful if I'd found that in the previous video. Never mind. Look at this. When the game runs well, or reasonably well, to a level that you can get a decent performance, then it is enjoyable. It is enjoyable. However, one of the things I have been thinking about, obviously we're having struggles with performance at the moment, and that's mainly probably due to the number of engines you see, locomotive engines, plus all the carriages and cargo and rolling stock, which are also on these massive trains. Absolutely huge these trains are. So when it comes to, say, if they bring in something like a European-style commuter train with two to about four or six carriages, then you may see improvement shoots up because it's not rendering as many rolling stock and as many locomotive engines as they are. Right, Laura? She's got incredibly shiny hair, hasn't she? She's worth it. She really is. So this is very pleasant. Going through the American countryside, through the forest, through the wooded area, with a river down there, down in the valley. Absolutely lovely. It's going to be absolutely boiling in here. Maybe we can put the aircon on. We'll put blow only, because, you know, no, we won't go there. Things are going nicely. So she comes sleeking through the trees. Camera clipping through the foliage. Fantastic. Speeds are good. Should we do a quick camera check? Look at that, 32. Steady 30-ish frames. So, if it was like this all the time, then I'd be reasonably happy. It's just those areas where it just dies. It's a big shame. Really big shame. Hello, wave to the camera. Yes, we're loving it there. Absolutely loving it. Elbow on the side, leaning out. Gonna get a trucker's tan on that arm. But it's quite interesting, you can watch all the little bits of the wheels and the suspension working away. All independent. Of course, we've got the fuel tanks here. And we can, you are perfectly acceptable to go into the Cumberland yard, go into the refueling shed, pop off the fuel cap and fill your tank up. Yeah, pretty much you can do that, which is pretty good. But this is more like it. Performance. You know, because I thought the last two videos were a little bit too critical, maybe. I don't feel this is in a state, really, that it should have been released, but certain parts of the map, once you're out of the Cumberland Yard especially, the game isn't too bad. It's not brilliant, it's not too bad, though, and it's I think it's worth giving the positives as well as some of the negatives. And reading the Steam reviews, there's been quite a few negative reviews, which you always get. You always get with any game release. There's always, you know, it could be the best game in the world. People will always complain. They'll always nitpick. I wouldn't class this as nitpicking, to be fair. There are some serious issues that they need to address, but it's no way as bad as most people, some people, should I say, are making out. But as I said, if you're not absolutely desperate for this, I would hold off until they've done some more work on it. Just slowing it down now, we're just coming into, it's actually 35 here, we're speeding slightly, oh, we're speeding a little bit more. So let's just slow it down a second. We're going up to a 35. Release the brakes, we should be okay. I'm flicking the HUD, I'm flicking the HUD in and out, toggling it with the F1 key, just in case those who are watching are wondering and thinking, how the heck do I do that? F1 key. There we go. See, that is very pretty. That is very pretty. That is gorgeous, in fact. I like that very much. Okay, while we're fairly stable, let's go out and have a look what's going on. Do the old Titanic thing, arms stretched out wide. I'm the king of the world! Don't worry, Laura won't say anything. She's, she's watching. Yeah, so, you know, the modelling is lovely. I do like the modelling, it's very nice. I'm sure if my textures were on absolute max, I could probably read that a little bit better. But yeah, it's a farm over there. Got a massive bridge over there. It's pretty impressive. And we are picking up a bit of speed, so we better go back just to check on how things are going. We'll close the door so Laura doesn't get a cold nose. 31 miles an hour, it's okay, it's 35 here. Some junk in the river over there. Bit of a toot as we go over the crossing. Should have done that a bit in advance to let them know we're coming, but I was gallivanting on the front of the the engine. You can see the carriages and the cars all snaking behind us. Look at that, it goes on for miles. Still going, still going, still coming. And then we lose sight of it, and it's still coming around the previous corner. These trains are blooming powerful, I'd give you that, wow. To be able to pull that many cars and rolling stock is incredible. And we've got a beautiful green meadows and pastures here. This is what you want, living in the country, nice and peaceful, nice and quiet, and a thundering great locomotive rumbles by, and for the next hour you hear the rolling stock chinking and clunking behind it. Wow, kind of ruins your summer's day, wouldn't it? Okay, we're slowing down here, guys. Because we put the brake into... Can we put the brake into... What are we in? We're in release. Okay. If we hop up there, we won't do the mistake we did. Has this got a wheel brake on it? No, it doesn't. Okay, fine. Let's just... pop the brake there. I think I may have overshot the points a little bit. But that is the good thing about this train sim world. You can just make it up as you go along. So yeah, we need to back up a little bit. And the points over here. Or is this just the speedo? Is this the speedo sign? Got loads of old sleepers here. Look at this. What's this? It's a rock. So what I want to do is change our course and head down this track to our right here. We are due to go straight ahead, but I want to go down there. So I'm wondering if I can find the point somewhere. Either way, we're going to have to back up a bit. So let's stick the reverser into reverse. Give it some juice. Safety first. Now, this is the back of the train. Now, what I really like about this is that you'll see the... keep an eye on those carriages. You'll see them get pushed by the one in front, and you can see the physics at work. Here we go. Clunk, clunk, clunk. Okay, it wasn't the most dramatic thing in the world. But the fact that it does it, you can see the physics had to work all the way through all those carriages. Right, brakes on. Let's just hop out. That would be so good if we could change this over. I'm sure it's probably not going to let us. Look like it, electronic points. How does one change those? Let's go for a little wander. There's a little house up here. They'll probably get a little bit funny with us and ask, do you want to give up ownership of the train? Never. Never in a million days. So maybe then I can't go down there, which would be deeply disappointing. See, obviously we want us to go on that one. I don't know this game well enough to understand how we can... So it doesn't appear that we can change that. Unless there's a little... Can we open this up and go up there? I'd like to go up the signals. No. That's really disappointing. There's no way that I can think of to change these points. All I've got is the click, and I'm clicking. Clicking like mad, but nothing. Maybe it's hold and swivel, he says. No. Damn. That's a shame. I'd have liked to have gone down there, but not to worry, we'll continue on. So it's not as freeform as I hoped it would be, but it's still pretty good. You know, we can still just stop and get on with it. We haven't failed a scenario and been kicked out just because we decided to stop and play around a bit. It's fine. So we'll leave this bit in peace and get going. Okay, onward we go. What have we got? We've got 4 miles, got another waypoint. We're doing quite good. We're only doing 12 miles now. We can get up to about 35. But we are going slightly uphill. Got a 0.8% incline. Which is probably not the best place to stop and try and do a hill start, but we've done a successful hill start. It's used a lot of power, a lot of energy, but we've got going. Laura was thrilled. Laura? Laura? Oh, forget about that. Never mind. We're just coming into the town now where we're slowing down. So those of you who played the beta will recognize this area. This was where we picked up one of the first trains, if you recall. So with the... Laura, you got this? Oh yeah, she got the shake of the shoulders. She's all over this. So we've come into town. Cause a bit of a ruckus at the trains. Well, it's not really a train station, it's just a level crossing. It's been a good run, and it's been very enjoyable actually in this lovely sunny days. Got a little birds up there, look at that. There we go, there's another one. Yeah, got lovely birds flying high. Oh, we can't walk around the town. That is a slight disappointment, but we do have people walking around the town. Well, we have a person walking around the town, should I say. And we have a van driving around as well. Looks like one of those delivery ones. She's going to hit the... Whoa! Just took out the banister. Watch out, Nutter! Well, there's a gentleman just managed to dive to the side of the road there, honestly. Good, so there is life in the towns, and somewhere back there is the end of our trailer. We're going to leave it there. I hope you enjoyed this further look at... the hell is going on there? That's better. I hope you've enjoyed this further look at Train Simulator World, and try and bestow some of its virtues on you as well. There are some great bits and aspects to this game. You know, the fact that you can just stop anywhere, get out, do what you want. That is the freedom that we've all wanted, I think. Well, some of us have wanted anyway. It'd be nice if we could get a little bit further into the towns and explore, but I'm sure on some of the latter content, which is no doubt on its way, and some of the community created content, that will be a thing for sure. But for now, with a nice, 22 frames a second, kind of ruined the momentum. It felt a lot better than that, actually. We'll leave it there. Thanks for watching. I hope this has been a more positive review, as I was saying, and I'd like to do a balanced after the two, bit of a whinging and a bit of a silly videos in the past, so we can become a nuisance and maybe just disconnect the carriages, and we could just jog on and leave the carriages there to block. Well, it's not quite blocking the road. Anyway, I'm rambling. We'll leave it there. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.